Hello students, welcome back to All Four e-learning classes. In the last session we discussed about the properties of Coulomb's inverse square law. Now today the topic is electric field. Okay, see, electric field, we know that what is a stationary charge can produce a electric field. For example, if you place a charge at any point in the free space, let us take this is a point. If you are keeping a stationary charge, either positive or negative, at any point in the free space, around this charged particle, up to some extent, the field is modified here. Okay? Means, how can we define these electric field? Means, the space around the charged particle up to which influences the field, up to which influences is felt. Okay? Electric field can be defined as the space around the charged particle up to which its influences is felt is called as a electric field. Or in other words, it is also can be defined as the region around the charged particle in which an electric charge can experiences the electrostatic force. The space around the charged particle in which an electric charge can experiences the electrostatic force is called as a electric field. For example, we know that like charges are repels and unlike charges are attract. If here we are placing a positive charge and a negative charge is placed at some infinite distance, so now these two cannot attract because the negative charge not lies within the electric field. Okay, if the charged particle lies within the electric field, then only the attraction force or repulsion force will be exert. So from this we can say that what is the space around the charged particle up to which its influences is felt is called as a electric field. Okay, see, in case of, if you draw the electric lines of force, this is about the electric field. Now what are electric lines of force? Electric lines of force. Electric lines of force. So what is electric lines of force means? If you place a positive charge or a negative charge at any point in the free space, we know that as electric field is formed around those charged particles. If in that electric field, if you are place a unit positive charge, lesser magnitude of the positive charge in that electric field, okay, electrostatic force will be exert, either attractive force or the repulsive force, and the particle will be moves in a particular direction, the charged particle will be moves in a particular direction. If we trace that line, the path followed by the unit positive charged particle in an electric field is called as electric lines of force. The path followed by the motion of the unit positive charged particle in an electric field is called electric lines of force. If you draw one tangent, okay, along the direction of electric lines of force, it gives the direction of electric field at that instant. The tangent drawn in the direction of electric lines of force gives direction of electric field at that instant. For example, now you may take a isolated positive charge. Here we are taking a isolated positive charge. This is a positive charge kept. Whenever we are introducing a positive charge at any point in the free space, up to some extent, around this charged particle, up to certain region, what happens? Electric field is set up. Now if we place a unit positive charge near to the this positive charge, we know that it may repulse. So if we draw the, if we trace that motion of the unit positive charged particle in this field, it may comes like this. The positive charge moves outwards, radially outwards. The lines of force are radially outwards. These are the lines of force. Okay, if you place a positive charge here, nearby the positive charge, obviously it ripple, it moves along outwards, radially outwards from the charge. If you trace the line direction of lines of force along these directions, So like that we can draw the number of lines of force here. So these are the electric lines of force in case of isolated positive charge. Isolated positive charge. Now coming to the, if you take a negative charge here, let us take this is our negative charge. A negative charge is placed in the free space. Even though what happens, an electric field is set up around the charged particle. Now if you place a unit positive charge at any point in the electric field, then positive charge, unit positive charge is attracted by the negative charge or not? So the lines of force will be like this. The path, if you tracing the lines, trace the lines. So this is a direction. If you place a unit positive charge here, it is attracted towards the negative charge. If you join that line, so the direction of electric lines of force is radially inwards. Radially inwards in case of isolated negative. Okay, this is isolated negative charge. These are the electric lines of force in case of isolated positive charge. What is the difference here? The lines of force is radially outwards from the charge. But whereas in case of electric lines of force in the negative charge, the lines of force is radially inwards. Okay. Now you may take dipole between the two, one positive and negative charge. Let us take this is a positive charge and here we are placing a negative charge. Electric lines of force in case of dipole. See, what is if you are placing a unit positive charge in the combined electric field, combined electric field of positive and negative, the lines of force are from positive to negative. If you place a positive charge here, unit positive charge, it is repelled by the these positive charge and attracted by the negative charge. Okay, the lines of force will be comes along this direction. Here the directions are important. Okay, positive to negative. And if you are placing here, it may move along this direction. If you place here, it comes downwards. So this is a direction of electric lines of force. Okay, in case of electric dipole, this is called as electric dipole. Okay, electric lines of force in case of electric dipole. Okay, and you may take either both are positive charges between the electric lines of force in case of between two positive charges or between two negative charges. So if for example here we are taking between two positive charges, this is a positive charge and here we are taking another positive charge. Two are positive charges. If we place a unit positive charge in between these two, the unit positive charge is repelled by the these two positive charges. So the lines of force will be along this direction. Okay, these are the electric lines of force in case of between two positive charges. Okay, if you are observing all these diagrams, okay, that means electric lines of force in case of different cases. From these observations, we can say the properties of electric lines of force. See, first one, what is electric lines of force means? Electric lines of force is nothing but it is a motion of the unit positive charged particle placed in an electric field. The path followed by the unit positive charged particle in an electric field is called as electric lines of force. And the second one is, if we draw one tangent line in the direction of electric lines of force, it gives a direction of electric field at that instant. The tangent drawn in the direction of electric lines of force gives direction of electric field at that instant. That means from these we can say that in case of isolated positive charge, the electric field direction is radially outwards, but whereas electric field formed by the negative charge is radially inwards. And what are Third point is, in case of isolated positive charge, the electric lines of force are started at the charge and goes on, moves radially outwards. Electric lines of force are started at the positive charge and ends at infinite distance in case of isolated positive charge. In case of isolated negative charge, the electric lines of force start at infinite distance but closed at the charge. Okay? And in case of an electric dipole, what is the electric lines of force are starting at the charge? Okay, they started at the positive charge and ends at the negative charge. Means they diverging from the positive charge and converging into negative charge. So that here we can say that electric lines of force are open curves. Electric lines of force are open curves. Just they started at the positive charge and ending at the negative charge. Okay. And one more thing, if you are observing these, the region at which the electric lines of force are crowded, if you are observing these diagrams, the electric lines of force are closer nearby the charges, and if you are moving away from the charges, they are sparse. The region at which the electric lines of forces are crowded, their electric field strength is stronger. The region at which the electric lines of force are sparse, far apart. For example, you may take these, in this case, positive charge. Now, what is the nearby the charge? The distance between any two electric lines of force is less. But if you are moving away from the charge, what is the distance is gradually increases. Means the region at which the electric lines of forces are crowded closer to each other, their electric field strength is stronger. The region at which the electric lines of force are sparse, far apart, their electric field strength is weaker. Okay. And electric lines of force are, these are imaginary lines. Electric lines of force are imaginary lines. There is no physical evidence. We cannot prove the electric lines of force. Okay. Practically, it is not possible. Just these are the imaginary lines. And one more, the other property is, electric lines of force are do not intersect with each other. Electric line, in these four diagrams, no two electric lines of force are intersecting at any position or at any point. Electric lines of force do not intersect with each other. Because if they want to intersect, at the point of intersection, electric field must have two directions. But practically it is not possible. So that electric lines of force do not intersect with each other. So these are the properties of electric lines of forces. What is, first of all, electric field means the region or the space around the charged particle, okay, up to which its influences is felt, is called as electric field. Or in other words, the region around the charged particle in which an electric charge can experience the electrostatic force is called as electric field. What are electric lines of force? Electric lines of force is nothing but the path followed by the motion of unit positive charged particle placed in an electric field is called as electric lines of force. And these are the properties. In case of isolated positive charge, electric lines of force start at the positive charge and ends at infinite distance. Isolated negative charge, they start at a longer distance but ends at the charge. But in case of dipole, they start at the positive charge and ending at the negative charge. So that electric lines of force, we say that these are the open curves. Compared to the magnetic lines of force, magnetic lines of force are closed curves. Okay? And in case of between the two point charges, these are the direction of electric lines of force. The region at which the electric lines of force are crowded, their electric field is stronger. The region where the electric field lines are sparse, their field is weaker. No two electric lines of force intersect with each other. If they want to intersect, at the point of intersection, field must have two directions. But practically, it is not possible. So, electric lines of force do not intersect. And one last, finally, electric lines of force are imaginary lines. There is no physical evidence to prove these lines of force. But whereas magnetic lines of force having the proof, we can prove that. But these are just imaginary lines. Next one, intensity of electric field. Intensity of electric field, it is a vector quantity denoted by E bar. Okay, see, intensity of electric field, we know that what is electric field. Now what is intensity of electric field? So if you place a point charge at any point in the free space, we know that around the charged particle up to some extent, what happens? The field is modified and electric field is felt. Now if you place another positive charge or negative charge within the electric field, then only it experiences the electrostatic force. What is intensity of electric field means? The mathematical, it can be written as E is equal to F by Q naught. So it can be defined as the force experienced by a unit positive test charge placed in an electric field. Intensity of electric field at any point can be defined as the force experienced by a unit positive test charge placed in an electric field is called intensity of electric field. So the mathematical form is E bar is equals to F bar by Q naught. E bar is equals to F bar by Q naught. It is a vector quantity. It is a vector. Okay. And what are the units? SI units. Units is force units Newton, charge units Coulomb. So units for intensity of electric field is Newton per Coulomb, and we have another units, that is volt per meter. Volt per meter, we have a relation between the intensity of electric field and potential. From that we may write the units of intensity of electric field is E is equal volt per meter. This is about intensity of electric field. Okay, now what is, if it is a vector, we should specify the direction. See, if the source charge is positive, first one, source charge is positive. What is the source charge means here? The charge which is producing the electric field is source charge. Source charge is positive, direction of electric field is radially outwards. Direction of electric field is radially outwards. Okay. If the given source charge is negative, if the source charge negative, the direction is, direction of electric field is radially inwards. Radially inwards. Okay. If the source charge, the charge which is producing electric field is positive, the direction of electric field is radially outwards. If the source charge, the charge which is producing the electric field is a negative, the direction of electric field is radially inwards. Now, if a positive charged particle is placed within the electric field, a positive charged particles are placed within the electric field, then the direction of force acting on it is along the direction of electric field. If a positive charge is placed within the electric field. Now let us take, this is a, in this case, this is a source charge is a positive, place Q, kept at the point O. A charge Q is kept at any point O in the free space. So we know that an electric field is formed, okay, which is radially outwards. Okay, now if another positive charged particle is, let us take a Q naught is a unit positive test charge, is placed within the electric field, is placed within the electric field formed by these positive charge. So obviously what is these Q naught is there within the electric field. This is a positive, Q naught is also positive, it is repelled. So it moves away from the charge, means the force acting in the direction of electric field. This is a direction of F here. okay? Means if a positive charge is placed within the electric field at any point, the direction of force acting on it is in the direction of electric field. Okay, next one. If the source charge is negative, instead of positive charge, here we are taking negative charge at any point O in the free space. Now, what is the direction of electric field is? Radially inwards. Radially inwards. Okay, otherwise, okay, let it be, this is also positive. Now, this is also positive charge. What is the direction of electric field? We know that radially outwards. Radially outwards. Positive charge means always the electric field is radially outwards. Now, instead of positive charge Q naught, if you are placing a negative charge in the electric field, if a positive charge is placed within the electric field, the direction of force is along the direction of electric field. Okay, now again, same positive charge is taken, field is radially outwards. But here we are introducing a negative charge. Q naught is a negative charge is placing, minus Q naught. Now, what is minus Q naught? This is a negative and this is positive. The unit negative charge is attracted by these positive charge or not? So, obviously, these two are unlike charges. The Q naught is attracted by the Q. Means, if a negative charge is introduced within the electric field, the direction of force acting on it is opposite to the direction of electric field. Opposite to the direction of electric field. This is F. Direction of F. Okay. Simple important points. These two are, if a positive charge or positive charge is placed within the electric field, the direction of force is in the direction of electric field. If a negative charge is placed within the electric field, the direction of force acting on it is opposite to the direction of electric field. Okay. So, this is about intensity of electric field. The force experienced by a unit positive test charge placed within the electric field called intensity of electric field. Okay, next one is, we should derive the expression for intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Okay. Now, let us consider a point charge place Q. A point charge place Q is placed at any point O in the free space. Let O be a point in the free space. A positive charge is kept at any point in the free space. Now, we know that what is an electric field is formed around the charged particle. What is this? Is a positive charge. We know that what is the direction of electric field is radially outwards. This is the direction of electric field. Now, we should find the intensity of electric field due to a point charge. Now, consider a point within the electric field. Let us take, this is a point P. Lies within the electric field formed by this positive charge. Okay. Now, up to the point P also electric field is there here. Okay. Now, we are considering a point P. Okay. Within the electric field formed by this source charge Q. Now, the point P is there at a distance small r from the source charge. Okay. What is the distance of point P? From this charge is R. Now, what is mean by intensity of electric field? The force experienced by a unit positive test charge placed within the electric field is called as intensity of electric field. So, for suppose we need to find intensity of electric field at this position, at the point P, there we should keep a unit positive test charge. Unit positive test charge. Okay. Always the magnitude of the test charge must be less than the source charge. Otherwise, if the magnitude is of the test charge is greater than source charge, the position of the source charge only changes. Okay. Now, here we are placing a unit positive test charge. Let it state this is Q naught. Okay. We are testing how much force is acting on a given charge. Okay. Unit positive test charge. Okay, we are testing the force so that it is named as a test charge. okay, Q naught be the positive test charge. Now Q, Q naught, these two are like charges. Obviously they repelled with each other. The Q naught is repelled by the plus Q. By the Coulomb's law, what is the electrostatic force acting on Q naught? Electrostatic force acting on Q naught electrostatic force acting on Q naught is F is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught Q Q naught Q1 Q2 means Q Q naught. What is the separation here? R Q Q naught by R square. Okay, now what is the direction of force? Because it is a positive charge, the direction of force is in the direction of electric field. This is a direction of a force. Okay, now we got the force, but what should here we should calculate? Intensity of electric field. By the definition of intensity of electric field, by the definition of intensity of electric field, okay, what is E bar is equals to F bar by Q naught. Okay, what is the magnitude? E is equals to F. What is the value of F? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R square. This is the value of F. By Q naught is there. Again Q naught. Q naught, Q naught get cancelled. Therefore, E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So this is the magnitude of intensity of electric field. The magnitude of intensity of electric field due to the point charge E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. But it is, we know that already we said that what is the intensity of electric field is a vector. So in vector form, E bar can be written as E bar is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square into R cap. Okay, where R cap be the unit vector along the line joining the OP. R cap be the unit vector along the line joining between O and P. So this is about a vector form of intensity of electric field. Okay, what is the direction? If the source charge is positive, the direction of intensity of electric field is radially outwards. If the source charge is negative, the charge is negative, the direction of electric field is radially inwards. And if you are observing this equation, what is E is equal to here? The intensity of electric field due to the charge Q at a distance r. At a distance r, we got 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. See, for suppose if R value is changing, so if you are moving closer to the charge, instead of point P, here we are taking Q. We should find the intensity of electric field at the point Q, capital Q. Now the distance R is decreasing or not? When R decreases, what is from this equation we may write like this. Intensity of electric field is inversely varies with the square of the distance. Inversely varies with the square of the distance for the given charge. Charge kept at constant, but we are calculating the intensity of electric field at different positions. When R value is less, whenever we are calculating the intensity of electric field closer to the this point charge, R is less, intensity of electric field is more, E proportional to 1 by R square. When R value is decreasing, that implies intensity of electric field is increases. When R decreases, intensity of electric field increases. So already in the properties of electric lines of force also we said that nearer to the charge, electric lines of force are crowded, closer the region at which the electric lines of force are closer, their field strength is stronger. Theoretically, we can say that, and from this equation also we can say that if R is less, that is closer to the charge, what is E value is more. So intensity of electric field varies inversely with the square of the distance. Okay, this is about intensity of electric field due to a point charge.